Good morning. This is my third lecture and the topic on power system instrumentation is PLCC, which is nothing but power line carrier communication, in which we can implement if this power line carrier communication on meter, electrical meter. So there will be automated meter reading system that will be crop up. Now for this, of course, I have taken the help of Eastern Red Oil Company, which is nothing but a ISO 9001:2000 company. It's a very well renowned company. So we will go to the objective of this power line carrier communication. Now first of all, tell me, what are the contents? First, present status of LT energy metering system in domestic, issues with other communication networks, critical benefits from PLCC communication, PLCC based automated meter reading network architecture, primary components and advantages. These all are the contents of this lecture, where all of them are contributing equally, or all of them are having equal importance in this lecture. Now coming to this portion, just see over here, what is the present status of LT energy metering in domestic? As you can see over here, if we have to measure energy, there will be various utilities. That means there will be various utility product, whatever we are seeing in the market, and still they are using electromechanical meters and low-cost digital meters. Accuracy class is 1 and above. That means still we are using electromechanical meters along with the low-cost digital meter, which we talked in previous video lectures also, just like digital voltmeter. Just see over here, the line loss rate, it is estimated to be much beyond 20% due to tempering. Whenever there will be tempering, it will create inaccuracy. It will create inaccuracy in the reading. So, of course, whenever we have to measure some particular parameter or variable, we have to see, or we have to account for this thing, that the loss rate, whatever we are getting from supply line, that should be less, that should be optimum. If it is more than the optimum value or optimized value due to tempering, then it will create inaccuracy in the reading. That means our objective will not be served. The third one, readings of the meter is done manually, which leads to obvious error. Of course, whenever we are doing meter reading if we are doing it by ourselves, then there will be parallelex error. Of course, systematic error of the instrument will be there, and of course there will be wastage of time. Suppose we are taking one reading, say for 10 to 15 minutes, but in this case, whenever we are taking reading, if there will be some difficulty which will arise by parallelex error, then the whole system is a type of wastage for us. It's a wastage of time, it's a wastage of resource and manpower. So what is our objective? Just to get the correct output and to remove the erroneous values. Now it is difficult to make exact load consumption analysis. What is load consumption analysis? That means whenever we are using some meter, there will be loading effect. That loading effect is creating transient effect on any digital meter. It will be very much difficult just to understand what will be that load, what will be that loading effect that will be consumed within the system. That's why it is written over here. It is very difficult to make exact load consumption analysis because there is no accurate method for this particular analysis nowadays. Still, now coming to the next slide, issues with other communication network. What are the issues? First, highly depends on other mobile network. Whenever there is mobile network, that means we are knowing that air or vacuum will be the medium. And whenever air and vacuum will be the medium, of course there will be interference. As we are knowing that from a sender to a receiver, whenever, suppose this is the sender, this is the receiver, whenever any signal is going, so it has to cross three level: measurement level, detection level and interference level. So these three levels are very, very important, because if there will be no accurate measurement technique is associated in this process, then we cannot get the exact output value, that is the observable experimental value. Of course we have to detect what are the hindrances present over here. According to that, the system should manipulate itself. And third one is very important: interference. Whenever the signal is coming very near to the earth surface, there will be obvious interference. Now this second point: accessibility of mobile network in remote areas is not available. Of course, in remote areas there will be some coin drop. There will be no access of the signal, because whenever the signal is going, it is going like this way. This is the way, the linear shift of the signal. Of course, this is the parabolic shift. Like this, the signal is going from sender to receiver. But if the signal is restricted within a certain limit, of course, then it cannot reach from the sender to a receiver. Suppose if I will tell you that the sender person is situated at a distance of 500 kilometers or 5000 kilometers from the receiver, then it will be very much difficult, or the call that will, or the signal that will come from the sender to the receiver will be a truncated one. That means it will be mixing with noises. The third case: in many cases manual reading is also not feasible. Of course, manual reading is one checksum method with the automatic reading. That is not possible in some cases. So billing cycle requires excessive time. That means whenever we have to bill for this consumption, that cycle, that particular thing will take excessive time period more than the requisition. And system maintenance, this is the very important thing. That means service after sales and as well as maintenance, it will become very expensive. Coming to the next slide, critical benefits from this PLCC communication. This is the most economically viable technology for transferring metered data to distributed control unit. That means at one position we are taking some data, we are transferring that data to some distributed control unit, and this is most economically viable technology. That means it will be taking less time, it will be saving human resources, that is manpower, it will be saving money also. Now see the second term: using this technique of communication, The data can be transferred over the existing LTE power lines. Of course, this is a very unique thing, as this data can be communicated from a metered to distributed control system. It can be transferred to the LTE power lines also, the existing LTE power lines. Narrowband direct sequence spread spectrum, which is this? This is DSSS. What is DSSS? Actually, in direct sequence spread spectrum, what will be happening? There is one particular data. That particular data is along with two types of signal. One is narrowband, one is wideband. According to that, there will be spreading of data and despreading of data to get the original signal mixed with narrowband and wideband signal. If we will use the frequency range in the lower region, then we will find out narrowband direct sequence spread spectrum, power line carrier communications technology, because of course this will be transferred to LTE power lines. The last one, encryption is provided for to ensure the data accuracy, integrity and security. This is very important, data accuracy, integrity and security. That means in no way the data will be tampered. Of course, there will be some checksum calculation for which this encryption is provided. Now, coming to the next slide. Benefits of PLCC automated meter reading. Benefit categories. Operational savings. That means it can be used in various operational sectors where there will be savings of manpower, optimum utilization of manpower, optimum utilization of money. Just see the supply side savings. Of course, whenever there will be demand, there will be supply. If the demand will increase, then the supply will be increasing also, but at a substantial rate. There are new revenue opportunities, which is a very important thing. That means these benefit categories can be applied, can be implemented as a provision of new revenue into various sectors. Now the new frontier, power quality. We can enhance the quality of power. We can enhance as well as we can enhance the security, as well as we can ensure about the integrity, security and sanctity of the output. Reliability improvement, that means there will be an improvement on the reliability for that particular system. Coming to the next slide. Now just see, what are the operational savings, what are the supply side savings, what are the new revenue opportunities. If we will go for operational savings, then there will be real-time meter reading. Real-time meter reading means, of course, whenever we are getting some meter reading that is with respect to time, that is known as real-time meter reading. No estimated bills. There will be no estimation. There will be no haphazard type of things in the billing. The meter is working in an absolute, with an absolute accuracy. So there will be meter accuracy. Is in maintenance of the automated meter reading system. Of course, if you will go for the maintenance for automated meter reading system, it will be very much easier. An outage care center, that means there will be an assurance about the exact output, and if not, then proper troubleshooting will be there. As well as outage investigation and follow-up. That means if the proper output is not coming, it should be investigated, it should be troubleshooted, and as per that, the following methodologies has been, following methodologies have been taken care. So of course there should be some follow-up. Outage reliability indices. This is a very important thing. Of course, the system should be reliable in nature. Load research, we have to take the loading effect. What is the loading effect associated with the system? And as per that, we have to make the analysis in the form of research, and we can count for that loading effect. We can measure that loading effect by analysis. Current diversion, that means now it is going from normal meter to distributed control system and to LT power lines. So there will be current diversion and collections of all those data in conjugated way. So it's a very important thing whenever we are talking about this operational savings. Now coming to the supply side savings. In the supply side savings, there will be distribution planning. Whenever there will be distributed control system, of course, or this distributed control unit, of course, there will be proper distribution planning. There will be proper transmission planning, how the data will be transmitted smoothly, seamlessly, effortlessly from sender side to receiver side. There will be generation expansion, that means there will be future scope, there will be a providence of future scope in this. So for next generation we can use this load forecasting. We can analyze, we can assume where the loading effect is actually implementing itself, and as per demand there will be response. So these are the things which are associated with supply side savings. Coming to new revenue opportunities. Number one, power quality monitoring. Monitoring of power quality in power system is a very basic thing. If there will be no proper monitoring, then power quality can be tempered or power quality can be reduced. Power outage notification, that means we have to see what will be the proper power output, whether we are getting the proper output or not from a system. Kilowatt demand monitoring, of course, this is a very important thing in terms of power. Power in terms of kilowatt, whether it is meeting the demand or not. Kilowatt threshold alerts, if it is coming below the threshold value, it will give some alarming signal, because threshold is the minimum value, below that there will be no supply. Load profile data services, this is also a very important point where we can say that we can graphically represent the load, the data, the power in terms of distribution, in terms of output with respect to certain input. So in short, these are all the whatever we have seen over here. These are the particular savings for operational, for supply side, along with the new revenue opportunities. Coming to this thing, quantifiable benefits. What are the benefits in terms of quantity? First of all, it will reduce the expenses. That is a very important thing. Of course, if there will be huge cost associated with this, then there will be a havoc problem. Suppose there will be less number of manpower, but there will be huge expenses, then what's the use? Here it will optimize the manpower, it will optimize the resource, it will optimize the expenses also. More effective planning. Of course, in this we can apply effective planning in a channelized way so that there will be substantial amount of quantifiable benefits. Minimize the losses. If losses will be more, what's the use to get data? Then the data will be erroneous, so it will optimize or it will minimize the losses, all types of losses in power system. Reduction in capital expenditures. Whenever there will be reduction in expenses, there will be reduction in capital expenditure, and that is a most important quantifiable benefit. And last one, new revenue opportunities. Of course, it will create, it will give new dimension for, or it will give new dimension as per revenue in terms of opportunity. Intangible benefits, customer service benefit, that means it is customer friendly. As per the specifications, as per the demand of the customer, the service will manipulate itself and give the ultimate or optimized benefit to the user. Improved relations with customers, that is also very important thing. That means whenever there will be a problem, there will be proper monitoring, there will be proper troubleshooting, and in this way it will improve the relationship with customer. And last of all, strategic benefits. Of course, this is a very important thing. Whenever there is a good system, there will be some fruitful strategy to get the ultimate benefit from it. So all these are the intangible benefits. Now just see over here, the enterprise architecture of AMR system. This is the customer here, IVR Solutions. Here we are making the call. This is the energy audit application. That means how much the power will be consumed, how much the power will be distributed, what is the cost associated with it, for that what is the billing, all those things will come over here. And this is geographical information system application, GIS application. Whenever it will be going to a remote system, from a local to a remote system. This is the business support layer. So this particular thing is related with business, that means the expenditure section. Now this is the master database. We can see over here, this master database, through internet, it is connected with custom data management system. That means here, all the data will be managed. That means what data will go afterwards, what data will go previously, all those things will be managed over here. This is the local database. You can see over here, bidirectional arrows have been given over here. Between master database, internet, custom data management system and local database. Last of all, there is billing application, which is, all these things are coming under operation support layer. So this is another important thing, business support layer, then operation support layer. As per hierarchy, if I will go from below to up, device, data, operation support and business support will come. Coming to data layer, you can see over here, master database is over here. These are all things which is related with different types of communication, like forwarding of data, DSL, general packet radio service, or VSAT or BB. Whenever the data is going from master database through internet to the local database. You can see over here, internet or GSM, global system for mobile communication is given over here. And at last it will be going to the destination. It may be some PLCC modems, it may be RF, it may go in the form of RF, it is GPRS or GSM. We are using RS-232 and RS-485 protocol for this in the data layer. So data layer is equally important with business support layer and operation support layer. Now coming to the next portion, you can see over here, as this is the device layer, ADLS is given over here and various metering system are given over here. Various types of system, whether this system is in your house, whether it is in some company, in some warehouse, company, maybe any software company, maybe any hardware company, everything is given over here. So if we will go to the next slide, this is the way how the data is going. Just see over here, PLCC based automated meter reading, network architecture, for LT commercial and domestic consumers. This is the HT line, high transfer line. This is the LT line, low transfer line. This is the distributed control unit. You can see the data is going to and fro from DCU and to DCU. Whenever you are seeing over here deep blue signal, it is telling that the data is going from DCU. And whenever you are seeing sky blue arrow signal, it informs us that data is coming to DCU. You can see over here it is written PSTN or GSM or GPRS or CDMA. That means by public switching telephone network or global system for mobile communication or general packet radio service or port division multiplexing as access. This is a particular base control station where this is the server and these are the computers or PCs associated with this server when this data is going. And data is coming from this to distributed control unit also, so it is bi-directional. If we will come over here, then we can see RU, the receiver unit. In the receiver unit, you can see data is going over here and from here also the data is coming back. So this is an unique feature by which we can see how the PLCC data flows actually. And there is no chance of conglomeration. There is no chance when two datas will collide each other because time is also fixed, so there will be no garbage values associated in this. So this is the basic PLCC based AMR network architecture for LT commercial and domestic consumers. Now this is the overview. In this overview you can see over here distributed control unit is given. Of course master switch control is given over here, ADSL is also given over here. There are so many things. You can see over here all those terms, it is coming as very faint, but I am telling you, it is telling you that particular thing that from HT line and LT line, how the data will go from distributed control unit to a modem. From that modem it will go to the server. From that server it will go to the destination point. From that destination point it will be conglomerated in a hub and from there it will go to another server, data server, and from there we can again accumulate the data. For that we are using what things over here? It is GSM or GPRS or PSTN or CDMA. We can use any of these techniques. All those things are very much important over here. Primary components. One phase and three phase direct connected or CT operated multifunction energy meter with inbuilt PLCC modem. This is one of the primary components. It may be working in single phase or it may be working in three phase. It is DC as well as it is CT operated multifunction energy meter. Data concentrator unit, as I told you, this is the distribution control unit where all the data will be concentrated. DCU with inbuilt PLCC modem for communication with meters. And of course GSM or GPRS or PSTN modem communicating with the central station and best computer software, which is the best service station. It is installed as master station server with GSM, GPRS or PSTN modem. So these are the all primary components related with this. Advantages. Advantages of, whenever we are talking about advantages of PLCC AMR, you can see over here, it will remotely connect or there may be any disconnection of power supply through PLC meter. It is a very important thing. Of course, suppose there is a local server and the destination is at remote place. Of course, for that the proper adjustment is made, as because all the communication is through GSM or GPRS or PSTN or CDMA. Now, ability to detect temper events and outage occurrences. That means wherever there will be any tempering, wherever there will be any malignant data, there will be the troubleshooting. Monitor electrical load in real time. That means what will be the load associated with the electrical system. It can monitor that particular thing. System has no running cost for data acquisition. Of course, single channel and multi-channel data acquisition system will be there, and for that there will be no running cost. Reduction in manual meter reading cost. This is also very important thing. There will be a proper reduction in manual meter reading. Reduction in late and estimated billing cost also. Of course, if at all there will be some particular reference given to a particular meter or a particular system, there will be late billing. Of course, there will be some estimation also, but there also we can see reduction. Improved meter accuracy and reduced meter maintenance expenses, as I told before. Reduction in revenue protection losses. Of course, if there will be any loss in the revenue generation technique, that should be protected properly, and there will be reduction in this. Prepaid metering can be done remotely without requiring local smart card or swipe card. That means without the NIC we can do this thing, and power quality, outage management and reliability improvement will be there also. Coming to the next slide. Of course, it is not there. I am telling you all these things are taken from Isan Rail Oil, which is ISO 9001:2000 company. So if I will go for a quick overview, I am just showing it over here. This power line carrier based communication used in automated meter reading system. It is consisting of present status of energy metering in domestic, what are the issues with other communication networks, critical benefits from PLCC communication, PLCC based automated meter reading network architecture, what are the primary components, what are the advantages. First part we have seen over here, I am just going for the recap. This is the first part for present status of LTE energy metering in domestic. This is the second part, that the various issues with other communication network. This is the third part where we are seeing the critical benefits from PLCC communication. This is the fourth part where we are seeing what are the benefits associated with PLCC automated meter reading, where benefit categories and new frontier will be there. This is the fifth part where there will be operational savings, supply side savings and new revenue opportunities. This is the sixth part where there will be quantifiable benefits and intangible benefits. This is the seventh part, that is the seventh slide, where the enterprise architecture of AMR system can be observable to us in four type of layer, where device layer, it is followed by data layer, then operation support layer, and at last business support layer will come. This is the next slide, which is telling us about PLCC based automated meter reading network architecture for LTE commercial and domestic consumers, where we can see the bidirectional data from data collection units to BCS like that. This is the next part where we are seeing overview of the PLCC AMR system. Every term is just written over here. This is the next part. BCS is actually nothing but base computer software, and data collecting or data concentrated unit, which is the distributed control unit. I've just told in my presentation. And then the advantages of PLCC AMR will be coming, which is followed by continued advantages. So these are the things actually which is coming under PLCC. My next lecture will be on microwave links and channel control capabilities. A pilot system will be there, which I will explain in the next class. Thank you very much.